Have you ever found yourself needing to upload a ton of files to something like Dropbox, only to realize that you don't have enough storage available on the service? So you either need to go through and delete a bunch of old files or just bite the bullet and upgrade. Or maybe you're like me and you consistently either forget or screw up the sharing permissions on Google Drive. Whenever I use that service, I swear I get that awkward email from the person I'm sending a file to being like, "Hey, I didn't get access to this. I thought you were good at tech. Could you please fix this?" It's so embarrassing. Well, today I'm going to offer a solution to both of those problems thanks to the sponsor of today's video, Sync.com. Sync.com is a cloud storage provider, just like Dropbox or Google Drive, but they offer truly unlimited storage. That's right, pay one fee, upload as many files as you like. And they have super awesome collaboration and sharing features that I promise even I can get right. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at the plans on Sync.com so you know which one to choose and which one is right for you. Now, if you're just an individual and you don't care so much about unlimited storage, you can start out for as little as $0. The free plan comes with 5 gigabytes of storage. So you can go ahead and try this out and see if you like it. If you want to ramp that up, you can go as high as 6 terabytes of storage for just $20 a month. Now, if you are a team and unlimited storage is important to you, in fact, even if just unlimited storage is important to you, you can go ahead and grab the Pro Teams Unlimited account here for just $15 a month. You do have to have at least 3 people on your team. So if you're an individual, $45 a month is going to get you unlimited storage. That's insane. That's a really great deal. Check the prices of storage. It is not cheap. So for one person, I still think that is worthwhile. Now, here is my favorite feature of Sync. You also get custom branding when you go to this Pro Teams Unlimited, which is going to allow you to basically create a portal where people can either give you files or you can receive files from clients. So if you're doing web design and you want people to be able to upload their copy or their brand assets, you can have a nice portal and with a couple of clicks that people can send you files. And if you're like me, I deliver a lot of video projects for clients. So it's just as useful to go the other way and have a nice branded folder that my clients can download their projects. So let me show you around the tool a little bit. And then later on, I'm going to tell you about a special offer that they have for viewers of my channel. All right, what you're looking at is a completely fresh, aka empty, Sync.com account. So this is the web interface, of course. There is a desktop app as well as a mobile app. We'll look at those a little bit later on. But for now, let's just get the lay of the land. Oh, I should mention that if you're the type of person that wants to follow along with a video like this, I do have a link in the description so you can go ahead and get started with an absolutely free Sync.com account right now. That is a referral link, so I appreciate everybody who clicks on it. It helps me out, makes more content like this on the channel. All right, so let's go ahead and get started here. I'm going to start by just creating a good old folder. What I love about Sync.com is how fast this is. You notice there was no delay or spinning wheel when I clicked add new folder, and I just call this like my folder and hit add. It shows up right away and I can start dumping things into it. So here is a video. I'm just going to throw this in here and you can see that there is a little file transfer screen. And as the file is uploading, I can continue to dump more and more files in. Of course, I could drag an entire folder as well, but I don't have to do that if you just have kind of piecemeal folders or files that you want to upload, some images, and we'll do a PDF as well here. All right, so everything uploaded super fast. You can see I can close this out here, and I am now inside of my folder, some breadcrumbs here at the top. So this is the root level here where it says sync.com. I've got my folder, and inside of that folder are all of my files. Now from here, you can do stuff that you'd expect to do, like I can open this up and I can see the actual file itself. I could create a share link, which is really nice. Now by default, when you click that share link, it's just gonna be available for people to look at. You don't even have to go in and click anything else to make sure that it's accessible like you do on some other platforms. I'm not bitter. All right, so I'm gonna copy this link and let's go ahead and look at what it appears like on the user end. So if I were to share this, before I do that, I'm going to show you the settings. So we can actually make this more private if we want. We could say that you can view this only, but you can't download it. Or we can enable comments from authenticated users, or just allow everyone to leave any comment they want on our files. Up at the top here, you can even set the file to expire so that if you give someone a share link, it's only good for a certain period of time. Or maybe you set a download limit so that people can only download it like 50 times and then it's no longer accessible. All right, so tons of sharing options here. It's really versatile. I'm gonna open this up in a private window and we can see what it looks like for the end user. All right, so here is that private window. I'm gonna go ahead and paste the link in, and you can see it pulls open here rather quickly. We've got the comments over here to the right. I didn't turn off that download button, so I can still download it. And let's go ahead and leave a comment. Now, notice when I click here, it does prompt people to either sign in. So they're trying to get people to sign up for an account, which is understandable, or I could sign in, or I could leave a comment anonymously. It looks like I didn't actually change that setting. So let's modify that. I'm gonna manage the link, go under link settings, and I'm gonna enable anonymous comments right here. And hit save settings. And now back on the shared page, I'm gonna hit reload, and now I can post anonymously. Nothing wrong with a little self-love, right? Now we can also create files from sync.com, and not just any old files, it integrates with Microsoft Office 365. So I can create Word documents, PowerPoint documents, Excel documents, and plain old text files if I don't use Microsoft. But for now, let's go ahead and let's create, oh, I don't know, how about an Excel document? And I'll call it my sheet and hit create. And sure enough, here we go. This is my spreadsheet. Now I have some different options when I click on this. Now I can actually edit this file directly in Office. So if you are a 365 user, you can go ahead and hit this button. It's gonna dump you right into Office and you can start editing it right away. Now I could also share an entire folder here. So if I wanted to share this folder, I could go ahead and share as link. And here we go, I've got an encrypted link, just like the individual file that I could then share with anyone I wanted. If I wanted to email this out, I can go ahead and send them a nice little message and do it right inside of the web app. If we go under link settings, we have the exact same permissions that we saw earlier when we were sharing an individual file, except now people will be able to view all of the files. Now there's another way to share folders in sync, and that's called a shared folder. For this, everyone who's going to access the folder is actually going to need to be a user of sync.com. They don't have to have a paid account, but they have to have at least a free account. The difference here is, of course, that shared folder will be available to them when they log into their sync.com account. They don't have to access a direct link. It's just inside of their sync account. So when you create a shared folder, you'd simply enter in the shared folder name, invite your users, set their permissions, and then go ahead and hit share. Now you'll be able to tell the difference between a shared folder and a non-shared folder, because obviously the shared folder has a little person on it. There's also these people that show up over here in the user interface. With any file, if there's things that you need to get access to all of the time, you can go ahead and star them. So I'm gonna click right here next to my avatar, and now this file is starred. In the menu up here, I have a starred tab. When I click into that, I'm gonna see all of my starred files. This is great for things that you need to reference frequently. You're not sure what folder they're in. You just want quick access. You can star them, basically like favoriting a file and getting very, very fast access to it, either to download it, share it, do whatever you want. All right, there are a few more features of sync.com that I want to show you that I think are really amazing. But first, we're going to dip over and take a look at the desktop app as well as the mobile app, just so you can see things from a different perspective. All right, so I'm on sync.com/install right here, and you can see that it's detecting that I'm on a Mac and offering me this file. I'm going to go ahead and download this, but while I do that, I'm going to point out that it is available on Windows as well as iOS and Android. Installing the app is super easy. You just move the app over to the applications folder, and then follow the standard protocol for opening up an app for the first time on your given operating system. So it's gonna ask me for a ton of permissions. I have to log in with my sync account. You'll choose a folder location, and just like that, the installation is complete. And now here on my menu bar on my Mac, I've got a little sync icon showing that all of my files are in sync between the cloud and my Mac. I can click on these icons at the top. So if I wanna go right into my Finder to go right to my shared folder, I can do that. And you can see here, it's called sync. Maybe I'll move this up to the top. And here are the same folders that we were just working on inside of the browser. This one's called my folder. And here we have the shared folder. If I open this up, you can see all of the exact same files have already been downloaded to my computer. If you ever want to share a file from your desktop, just go up to the icon in your menu bar, search for the file that you want to share, like the themes video that I uploaded earlier. Then I can click on the little cloud icon right here, and that's going to open it up right inside of the web browser where I can easily create my share link. Of course, any new folders or files that I create while I'm on my desktop will show up right away inside of sync. I'll just show you my test folder, and I will add another image here to that test folder. And when I open up the browser, I'm gonna go back to the root level here, find my test folder right here, and it's already got the logo that I just uploaded right there. So everything works flawlessly back and forth between desktop and web. And getting started on iOS or Android is just as easy. I went ahead and searched for sync.com on the App Store here. I'm gonna go ahead and download the app, install, open it up, log in. And there we go, I've got access to all of my files right here. I can go ahead and view any of the files that I've already uploaded. Like I wanna look at my avatar here. I can go ahead and edit this, rotate it. I can duplicate it. star it, get a sharing link. All of the same stuff we saw in the web app is present in the iOS app. If you want to add more files right from your phone, you can just hit the plus button here and be able to upload a file or an image very easily. Or I can even create a file right here on the phone. And once again, it's going to be a Word document or a PowerPoint or anything that I like. But wait, there's more. Back over in the web app, I want to show you a few more exciting things about Sync. First of all, there is a version history to everything you do on sync.com. So that way, if someone makes a change to a file and you're not happy with it, you can always go back in time. Let me show you how this works. So I'm going to create a file here. I'm going to make it a plain text file just for the sake of editing. And here it is. So now what I'm going to do is open this up on my desktop and I'll make some text edits. I'll hit save. And now over on the web, I can go ahead and open up this file. And of course, I see the preview right here, but I can also see the version history and I can see the changes that have been made. So if I wanted to go back in time, I can simply click over here and restore to a previous version. I can see all of the information about who edited the file and what device they edited it on, whether it's on a desktop or a web interface. Another feature I think you're going to love is kind of ironic given the name of the product is Sync, but Vault allows you to have files on sync.com that are not synced to your devices. So the idea here is that if you have files that you don't want to get rid of, you can put them in your Vault and they're not going to take up any storage space on your Mac or your PC, but they will still always be available to you from your apps. So that is absolutely amazing. There are other ways to do this with other apps, but it's kind of convoluted. You have to go in and choose which files are syncing in folders and it gets very complex. I love the simplicity of sync.com. Here's the Vault. This is stuff that you're done with, that you don't want to deal with anymore, but maybe you will someday. So put them in the Vault. It makes a ton of sense to me. All right, a big thing with sync.com is teams and collaboration. So let's get into that next. Now, the first thing you're going to want to do when you create your sync.com account is add all of the users in your organization. So there is a user panel up here and you can see I am currently the only user, but I can go ahead and add more users if I like. I've got 3 on my account here, so I can easily add more at no additional cost. I'll go ahead and add the wife here and invite her. And now she's going to get an email to join the team. I can see that she hasn't accepted it yet because it just says invitation sent, but I added her as a default user. So she's not gonna have all of the same permissions that I have. Under the roles tab here, we can see what those permissions are all about. So we've got the administrator and the default user, but I can add additional roles if I want. There's a lot of different options here to specify exactly what people can and can't do, which is obviously huge when you're collaborating with a large team of people. You don't want people to be able to edit other files or change links, purge the trash can. You can choose exactly what they can do. If you're really security focused, and you should be, you can even force two-factor authentication. As an administrator, you're going to be able to track how everyone is using your sync.com account. In the events tab up here, I can see a list of all of the actions that have taken place on my sync.com account. Most of them happened since I started recording this video today, but you can see how useful this would be if you are really concerned about security and what's happening with your actual files. Now, once you've got all of your users onboarded to Sync, you can go over to the sharing tab up here where you can see all of the files that your organization is currently sharing. You can see the team shares, which are your shared folders. We can see the links that we've created so that other people can actually access our files. And we can even see the files that are shared externally, which there are currently none shared externally. Now, this is a really useful feature to have all in one place because you don't have to go hunting around to see which folders or which files have I made public. Maybe there's some stuff that you need to take down and have mistakes in it, or is just no longer up to date. One place to click, find all of your links. I think that's a really, really nice feature. All right, let me show you how to make that branded folder I was just talking about. So the first thing I'm gonna do is click on my user account up here in the upper right-hand corner. And then I'm gonna go to settings. And if I scroll down here, I've got this custom branding option. I'm gonna click on this. And now here I can upload my logo as well as set my brand colors. All right, I've uploaded my logo as an SVG and you can see the little preview down here. I'm obviously having some color conflict issues between the default colors. So let's change the header bar color. I think I'm just going to stick with good old white here, and then I can change the text color to be a little bit darker. My buttons can be green, and then the button text as white looks good, and I'll make my links orange. All right, I'm going to go ahead and hit save here. And now the fun part, I want to collect files from a client. So what I'm going to do is just create a brand new folder here, standard folder, and I would name it, say, my client's name. I'll hit add, and then I'm going to share this folder, and I will share it as a link. But then I'm going to go under the link settings, and under upload permissions, I'm going to enable upload permissions. Now I've got two options here. I can show the existing files in the folder, which is good for a lot of clients because they want to see what they've already uploaded. But if it's just simply a place where people are dropping files off, you could turn that off as well. I'm going to leave it on for now and I'll hit save settings. All right, now let's grab this link and I'll show you what it looks like for the client. All right, so here we go. This looks great. It's got my logo in the upper left-hand corner. The links that I chose in the header section are green, and then the links down below are that orangish color. I can go ahead and have my clients just upload their files right here. No messing around with FTP or any of that nonsense. I actually love having a place for clients to send me files rather than having to rely on whatever service they use, because then I don't have files scattered about Dropbox, Google Drive, and then whatever other platform they have decided to use that week. All right, so that is sync.com. If you want to get started with your very own sync account, I've got a link below in the description, and there will be a limited time special offer for viewers of this channel. Even after that deal expires, I'll try to keep the link updated with the current sale or the best available deal. So make sure you check it out no matter when you're watching this video. If you've got any questions about sync or just cloud storage in general or really anything, feel free to hit me up in the comments. I also have my community. There's a link for that in the description as well. I'd love to have you join. That's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. I am Dave Swift, and I'll see you in the next one.